All right. Okay. Goeienaand. Good evening. Erev Tov. Let's find a seat so that we can start, please. And if I can ask you to sort of not sit widespread, let's like have a meeting here. So, welkom aan almal. Ons is vanavond een bykie dun, lyk het my, maar ek dink het is die reën wat op pad is waarskynlik. So, ek dink elkeen van ons vanavond, ek staan nou net en dink daan, onvermydelik. It's like James said a couple of weeks ago, tonight we've all got feelings. We're feeling hungry. Yeah, so, you're feeling hungry. All right, so we are going to, the format of tonight's story is, I'm going to have a couple of minutes, 10, okay, maybe 15 or so minutes, hopefully not half an hour, have an introduction, just sort of, there are new people around, and just have an introduction of what Yom Kippur the focus is a 10-minute introduction, and then what we are going to do is we're all going to stand, and then we're going to worship and pray. Okay, so, and it's we're going to take the format of a formal prayer. There is a Amidah, a standing prayer that is a traditional prayer. I've changed it with a messianic focus, and I've asked a couple of people to work through that, and as the prayer is read. Remember, it's a prayer. And it's a prayer thanking our Father. It is the blessings of the Father that has been proclaimed. And in between the prayers, we are going to have the worship team to lead us in worship. So it is the focus on tonight is a short talk, prayer, and worship. And then we're going to eat. All right. Okay. Wonderful. Okay. So let's just open with a prayer. Father, tonight as we assemble here in the end of the day, the Day of Atonement, our hearts are filled with gratitude, Father, for the work that you've done in our lives. Thank you, Father, for being part of your family, being part of a covenantal relationship with you, the Creator of all the earth. We praise you, Father, and we thank you for the opportunities that we have. That this time, Father, you have assembled us and you caused us to live in a time and in a generation that we believe is coming to a climax. And Father, we pray that we will be the tools in your hands to shine the light of the kingdom to the people of the world. We thank you and we praise you, Father. And Father, tonight while we're assembling, I just want to ask that the people that are suffering at the moment with flood damage and with threat of destruction of property, possible lives, we ask, Father, that your hand of protection will be over this part of the world and that you will protect us from disaster. We thank you for the rains that's falling, Father. The rain is a sign of your blessing, and we thank you for the blessing of this rain that's been bestowed upon us. But Father, we ask in your name that the rain will not cause destruction. We thank you and we praise you and we thank you for your perfect will in our lives. Amen. All right, so this is the day, Hayom. This is the day that creation is looking forward to for 6,000 years. And if we read in scriptures about in that day, or in this day, this is the day that scriptures are referring to. Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement. That the climax of this last, the month of Elul that has passed, is the month that we ask forgiveness and restoration, restoring of relationships and personal problems that we've been dealing with for a while now. And I think if we get to this night, tonight, this evening here, hopefully we have dealt with all problems that we are aware of. If there are relationship problems, relational problems that we sit with, I want to ask you, use the next while we're together, to ask the Father for restoration, for grace, for mercy. Give forgiveness. Ask forgiveness. Very important. This is the focus of this day, is that we will be prepared as the bride without spot, wrinkle, and blemish to meet our Maker, to meet our King. This is the day when Revelation speaks about that our Father and our Messiah set their feet on the Mount of Olives. The coming of the King. This is what we're talking about. In Acts 1 verse 9, as the disciples were gazing intently into the sky while Messiah was going, behold, two men in white clothing stood beside him, and they also said, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into the sky? This Yeshua, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in just the same way as you watched him go into heaven." And this is that day when he comes back that we're looking forward. And all the prophecies and everything that's pointing to Scripture comes at the fulfillment and the climax of the six millennia that men have spent on the earth. 120 jubilees. Remember, the Father said in the beginning that I will contend with man for 120 years. 120 50s is 6,000 years. This is the climax of creation as we see it. From here on forward, we build into the millennium. This is where we're going to. So there is a scarlet thread in the Bible that we know of so well of, and this is the core of what the Father has been doing in our lives for the thousands of years, and this is the scarlet thread of redemption. Right from the very beginning, when Adam and Chava fell into sin, this is the teaching of a coming Redeemer was told. The clothing of Adam and Chava, the skins of that the Father gave to them, cost the lives of innocent animals, pointing towards someone that will give his life for in innocence to those that are guilty. When Abraham took his son up to the mountaintop, this was the Redeemer that humanity was looking forward. When Israel was in Egypt, this is the scarlet thread of redemption that was talking, that the Father was that he had in mind. So every sacrifice in the tabernacle, every sacrifice in the temples that was made on the earth was pointing forward with this core teaching of redemption that the Father had. All pointing to the Redeemer of Israel, the Son of the Most High, that will be returning tonight, today, in a day, in a year to come. Remember, to a certain extent, the King is an exile. The kingdom of heaven on the earth is an exile. Because at the moment, the kingdom is functioning in you and I, but it's not seen on the earth. Jerusalem at the moment is not the capital city in which the high priest of heaven is functioning in. We are going in that direction. And by the offer of Messiah, he has prepared your life and my life as being covenant partners in establishing the kingdom of heaven on the earth. And this is where we are going. So as this scarlet thread of redemption is going on, there is actually a bigger picture that we're talking about. And remember, some time ago I put this picture, this image on the board. And it is, you can imagine yourself that this is the sun moving in a direction with speed. And this is the redemption story. That is the story of redemption that was prepared for us from way back when the Father created heaven and earth. But the bigger story, the circumference, everything that revolves around this, and the purpose for redemption is the restoration of the kingdom. The kingdom entails everything, but it's impossible without redemption. But redemption on its own isn't going anywhere if we don't have a kingdom that is restored. So the story of the kingdom is where we are going to. That is the golden thread of scriptures, right from the very beginning. The Father said to Adam and Chava, you can live in the garden, work the garden, but there is a tree. You've got a responsibility. The Father establishes himself as the one who reigns and makes the decisions. Right from the very beginning, he sets himself up as the King of glory. So the heavenly host and the earthly authority figures are created from the beginning in Genesis 1 and Genesis 2 to be able to position themselves. Remember in the Garden of Eden, there was a plan. And the plan was to populate the earth, to let the message of Eden, the message of the King, spread across the globe. Same story today. We are the earthly authority figures. In sin, Adam and Chava lost the dominion. But our Father, in covenantal relationship with you and I, restored that. And this is why we are the shining light. Like the light that we saw in the sun, we are a reflection of that light in the earth today. So his focus in our day is to restore the original message, restore the values that our Father has set off from the beginning, and to renew his message in the earth, to reign over the earth in glory and in power. The message of the kingdom was the focus of Messiah. Remember, he had 9 words. That was his teaching. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. That was Messiah's teaching. That was his focus in his life. So in his life, this was the message that he had. And to fully accomplish his task, he couldn't do in his first coming. Remember when he read Isaiah 61 in the tabernacle in Nazareth? He stopped in the middle because the day of vengeance hasn't come. But there is a day in the future with the name of Yom Kippur that the fullness of his task will be shown to the earth, and all kingdoms will be subject to his kingdom, and our Father will be all in all. This is a day that will come. This is the day that we're remembering on Yom Kippur. So, this proclamation that the Father is making in Revelation 11, 15 to 16, is not really made in heaven. It's made in a city on the earth. Think about this. It's the seventh angel. How many trumpets are blown? 7. We came from the day of trumpets with the last trump. The last trump was the big, long blast of a trumpet that you don't know when it's going to end because the day of his coming is unknown. But there is a trumpet that's going to blow on this day, the day where our Father blows the great shofar, his trumpet, on the day of the Jubilee, the announcement of the Jubilee. And that's the seventh angel that sounds. The kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Adonai and of his Messiah, and he shall reign forever and ever. It says, Adonai yimloch le'olam va'ed. We're going to say that a couple of times tonight. Adonai yimloch le'olam va'ed. If you learn any Hebrew, that's the Hebrew to learn. Our Father will reign forever and ever. That's what it says. The 24 elders who sit on their thrones before our Father fell on their faces and worshipped Elohim. That will happen in a Jerusalem that is established, where now the full revelation of his redemption and kingdom is shown. But right from the very beginning, Exodus 15:18, that words were proclaimed. Adonai yimloch le'olam va'ed. When Moses came out from the Red Sea and the enemy was demolished, and our father caused joy to happen in Israel's life, Moses said, the Lord God will reign forever and ever. Miriam danced, the horse and rider thrown into the sea. Israel proclaimed these words, and those words are meant for Yom Kippur. So, Zechariah 14:9 says, and Jehovah shall be king over all the earth, and in that day, this day, he will be one, and his name will be one. So how do we get there? How do we live in the power of the kingdom? We live our lives in the strength of his character. We learn to live in the strength of his character by what we talked about the weekend, Shabbat. It is when the knowledge of our Father is transferred into our spirits, into our hearts, by the Spirit of our Father and the studying of His Word. When that's fused into our beings, we have the knowledge of our Father, a relational knowledge with our Father, knowing where He's taken us. And His holiness, His set apartness can be shown in the glory that's revealed in the earth through your life, through my life, and in His mighty works. John 17:1, Yeshua said these words. He lifted His eyes up to the heaven and says, Father, the hour has come. Now glorify Your Son so that Your Son might glorify You. And this day in the future will be the glory of the Father shown across the earth. As You have given Him authority over all flesh, that He should give everlasting life to all whom You have given Him. In a day in the future, in a Yom Kippur, you and I will stand before the throne of our Father. Not a maybe, it's a given. We are going to stand before Him, and He is going to reward us. He's going to reward us as part of His household, as part of His bride, for the things, for the actions, for the works, for the words, for the relationship we had with Him. We need to prepare ourselves. That's why the Word says, do not accumulate the things of the earth for you, but accumulate the things that as of eternal value. So, verse 3, and this is everlasting life, that they should know the only true Elohim and Yeshua, the Messiah, who you have sent. This is everlasting life. We are preparing ourselves and busy to prepare ourselves for the days, difficult days that are ahead. But those difficult days are only a birthing process. It's a birthing process for the kingdom of Messiah that will establish itself on the earth. Revelation 1:7 says, behold, He is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see Him, even those who pierced Him. And all the tribes of the earth will mourn over Him. So it is to be. It's going to be a great day. It's going to be a day when the great shofar blasts and our Father's exile, of the exile of Adonai, will be cancelled. And He will return to the earth. He will be shown in glory in Jerusalem. We will all go to Jerusalem and we will praise Him forevermore. So, I think what we need to do is, wrong presentation. We need to get the right presentation. That's a good day. Still the wrong presentation. Tonight, we're not going to be in spectator mode. Okay? We are going to participate because you have a responsibility by living out the values and things of the kingdom as much as I have, as much as anyone here. So this is an invitation. We can so easily get into a sort of a relaxed spectator passive mode, but I want to invite you to get out of that tonight. We are here to enjoy this day together. And Psalm 51:17 says, Jehovah, open my lips that my mouth declare Your praise. Let's do that tonight together as we stand, because we're going to do the standing. And as we do that, we're going to say, Father, You are blessed above all. You are a God of compassion and mercy. To You be the praise and glory forever, and let Your ways be known upon the earth. Your saving power among the nations. And this is our heartfelt prayer from our hearts, is that as we live our lives, so that our Father, the compassion of our Father, will be shown in the earth, and that His ways will be known. How will His ways be known? Through Your testimony and my testimony. That's how His ways are shown in the earth. So blessed are You, Father, Lord our God, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the great and mighty and revered God, God Most High, the Creator who does kindness and who sent Your Son to Your children for Your name's sake with love. Remember John 3:16 says, because our Father loved the earth, everything happened. The story of redemption started way back when, because our Father loved us and still loves us. So, Together tonight we will declare that He is our King, our Helper, our Savior, and our Shield. So let us stand together. Let us stand together. Tonight we celebrate the return of our King. This is sort of a highlight in the days of humanity. It is the return of our King. And I ask some of our friends to read, help us to read through this prayer. And as we read through this prayer, I want you to, as they read it, pray it in your heart so that we together will declare His glory and His goodness and His mercy. Because there will be a day in future that Revelation 5 speaks about, which says, "And I saw in the right hand of Him who sat on the throne a scroll written inside and on the back, having sealed with the seven seals." Remember our Father's seal, His kingly seal of the Creator of the earth, is put on that scroll seven times. Who is worthy to open a seal like that? "I saw a strong messenger proclaiming with a loud voice, 'Who is worthy to open the scroll and to loosen its seals?' And no one in heaven and earth, under the earth, was able to open the scroll or to look at it even. And I wept much because no one was found worthy to open the scroll or to look at it. And one of the elders said to me, 'Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, overcame to open the scroll and to loosen its seals.' So You, O Lord, are eternally mighty. You give life to dead, and You have power to save, and You sustain the living with kindness, and You revive the dead with great mercy, and You support the fallen. You heal the sick, and You set the captives free, and You keep the faith with those who sleep in the dust. Mi kamocha, O Adonai, who is like You, O Mighty One, and who resembles You, King, who slays and gives life and makes salvation flourish? You are faithful to revive the dead." And I want us to, every time that these words come up tonight, we say it together. Adonai yimloch le'olam va'ed. Okay, so that was a good try, but that was not good enough. Let's just say it like you mean it. What do you say about this? Adonai yimloch le'olam va'ed. Lord God reigns forever and ever. Amen. And remember, the praises in heaven will be like thunder and lightning. And let's try to. We've got no sound effects tonight. No special effects that the movies and everybody else brings. It is up to you and I to declare the glory and the majesty of our Father together. So, let us sing and praise our Father.
For Your righteousness have been made manifest. We will sanctify your name in this world, just as it is sanctified in the highest heavens, as it is written by Isaiah. Let's say this together. Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. In Psalm 146 it is written, the Lord reigns forever, your God, O Zion, throughout all generations. Hallelujah. Throughout all generations we will declare your greatness, and to all eternity we will proclaim your holiness. Your praise, O God, shall never depart from our mouth, for you are a great and a holy God and King. You grant us wisdom and teach understanding to man. Favor us with your wisdom, understanding, and insight. Bring us back, our Father, to your word. Draw us near, O God, to your service. Bring us back to your perfect repentance. Forgive us, Father, for we have sinned against you. Pardon us, our King, for we have transgressed. For you are the one who pardons and forgives. Look upon our affliction and redeem us speedily for your name's sake, for you are our mighty Redeemer. Let's say together, mighty Redeemer, you conquered the grave. There is no other strong enough to save. You go before me, so I won't be afraid. Nothing is greater than the power of your name. Adonai Yimloch Le'olam Vayeh.
Heal us, Yahweh, and we shall be healed. Save us, and we shall be saved. For you are our praise. For you, Almighty King, are a faithful and merciful healer. Bless this year, Lord our God, with all its varieties of produce, to the glory of your name. Bestow a blessing upon the face of the earth, and satisfy it with goodness, and bless this year like the best of years. Sound the great shofar for freedom. Raise the banner to gather the exiles and gather us from the four corners of the earth. Adonai Yimloch Le'olam Vayeh.
Ascribe greatness to our Yah, the Rock. His work is perfect, and all his ways are just. Ascribe greatness to our Yah, the Rock. His work is perfect, and all his ways are just. Perfect, and all his ways are just. Ascribe greatness to our Yah, the Rock. His work is perfect, and all his ways are just. A Yah of faithfulness without injustice.
Restore our judges as in former times, and our counselors as at the beginning. And remove from us sorrow and sighing. Reign over us, you alone, Adonai, with kindness and compassion. Thank you for your compassion towards the righteous to all. Grant a good reward to all who truly trust in your name. Grant our portion with them forever, so that they may never be put to shame. For in you we trust. Return in mercy to Jerusalem, your city, and dwell in it as you promised. Rebuild it soon in our day as an eternal structure, and quickly set up in it the throne of David. Adonai Eloh le'olam va'ed.
Yahweh ons alleluia.
Yahweh ons alleluia. Hey.
Speedily return, O Yahweh. Cause Messiah to be revealed and glorified as King over all the earth, and let his stature be exalted by your saving power, for we wait all day for your salvation. Hear our voice, Lord our God. Spare us and have pity on us. Accept our prayer in mercy and with favor, for you are a God who hears prayers and supplications with compassion. Be pleased, Lord our God, with our prayers. Restore the service to the inner sanctuary of your temple and receive our prayers. May the service of your people always be acceptable to you, and let our eyes behold your merciful return to Zion.
The Lord reigns.
Father, we thank you. We give thanks to you, for you are Yotevave, our God, and the God of our fathers forever and ever. Throughout every generation, you have been the rock of our lives, the shield of our salvation. We thank you, and we declare your praise, for our lives are in your hands. Our souls are entrusted to you. Your miracles are with us, and your wonders and favors are with us at all times, evening, morning, and noon. Your mercies never fail. Your kindness never cease. We have always placed our hope in you. Your name, our King, is blessed and exalted forever and ever. Let every living thing give thanks to you and praise your name in truth, God, our salvation and our help. Grant peace, goodness and blessing, grace and kindness and mercy to all your people. Bless us, our Father, one and all, with the light of your face. For by the light of your face you have given us, Lord our God, a Torah of life, and love and kindness, charity, blessing, mercy, life and peace. Thank you for giving us Yeshua, the light of the world, and illuminating our path through the Spirit. Adonai Yimloch Leolam Vaed.
Worship His holy name. I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing all the goodness. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness. Darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life, all my life, you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. It's running after me. With my life laid out, surrendered now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now, I give you everything.
Father, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart find favor before you. O Yotevafe, my stronghold and my redeemer. And together tonight, as we imagine the great shofar that's going to blow in one day, let's say this together three times, a proclamation of his glory. Adonai himloch leolam vaed. Adonai himloch leolam vaed. Adonai himloch leolam vaed. Father, your goodness and your mercy is wonderful. And we thank you, Father, for making us part of your covenantal family. We praise you and we honor you for this day that you return for your kingdom. We bless you and we praise you and we exalt you with all of our hearts, with all of our minds and all of our beings. We glorify you, Father. We thank you, Messiah, in the name of our Father and our King. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Let the young men get the tables. Let the women prepare the food. And let the family eat together. Amen.
The goodness of God.
Your goodness is running after me.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life. It's running after me, your goodness is running after, it's running after me, your goodness is running after, it's running after me, with my life laid down and surrender now, I give you everything, your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
All my life.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness. The goodness of God, I will sing of the goodness of God, I will sing of the goodness of God.